Mshatta is known today mostly for the gorgeous architectural sculpture now housed in Berlin, but was once a desert palace for an early Islamic ruler. What you see in this picture are the remains after they were excavated in 1840 while they were still in their original location, 30 kilometers from Amman, Jordan. This desert palace was likely built by the Umayyad Caliph Al-Walid II. The interior of the Mshatta complex was never completed, but the lower course of stone had already been laid and showed that space was intended to house both a courtyard and a small mosque. It's the exterior walls, though, that have secured Mshatta's place in art history. They were a square, about 147 meters per side, and the exterior of the south wall had already been extensively adorned by the time construction stopped. The defining feature of the south facade is a gateway flanked by semi-octagonal towers. It's the sculptural ornament, though, that is truly noteworthy. The 40 triangles are almost 3 meters high, and while not all of them were completed, some are extraordinary works of early medieval sculpture. An intricate zigzag pattern gives the overall outline. They combine high relief with the central rosette and low relief of the detailed patterns of vines and various creatures such as centaurs, lions, griffins, and birds. The carved frieze deftly combined elements from art of the Roman East with those of Sasanian Persia. The scene of mythic creatures around a vase may have signaled to the original audience images of paradise. And in fact, this building could have been constructed to welcome pilgrims returning from the Hajj to Mecca. Or it could have been a desert home and commercial depot for the ruler Al-Walid II, who was assassinated after only 1 year in power, perhaps for his decadent behavior that allegedly included lots of sex, poetry writing and drinking, a time-honored combination. Charges like that were sometimes manufactured to justify getting rid of somebody after the fact. That said, this fragment of a woman's nude buttocks is one of the few freestanding structural pieces discovered at the site, suggesting the wide range of subject matter that was intended for this palace. Other so-called desert palaces of the Umayyads were adorned with nudes, and many other kinds of iconography such as constellations, animals, and courtly scenes of musicians and dancers, suggesting what may have decorated Mshatta once it was completed. The range of images decorating some of the better preserved desert palaces, which you can see were built over a wide area, raises questions about their use. The Desert Palace Mshatta is interesting too for differentiating its decoration of religious and secular architectural spaces. Because the area on the side of the mosque, on the south facade we'd been talking about, follows the Islamic prohibition of images, in contrast to the proliferation of life depicted on the other side of the Mshatta facade. By the 19th century, the building was largely in ruins, but the beauty of its sculpture was still recognized. The name Mshatta was given by the Bedouins living nearby. We don't know what the Umayyads called this building. The Prussian ruler received these sculptural fragments from his Ottoman counterpart, and the Umayyad building was moved from Jordan to be reconstructed in Berlin, and only a little bit was left behind, the non-sculptural parts. Damaged by World War II bombing, it was yet again restored and is now the monumental anchor to the Islamic collection on the Museum Island in Berlin.